Okay, so carrying on from last time, what I'm going to do is first of all, armature pool. I need to move that here. change up to this pattern as well, and then I'll work on the meshes, moving the mesh to the resource pattern. Looks like a better, there we go. Should be simple enough. Okay, application to application header, SFO resource. Did I not add this as part of the last one? I guess I didn't. Whoops. Fix up the last one. Okay. Okay, and then that means we don't need this one anymore. I didn't even need it anyways. That leaves meshes. Or actually, I'm going to have to like specifically say graphics mesh. This is going to be a type that also has uploading and uploading middle step as well. That's not going to be fun. These are the same. got, what we got, what we need. Whole bunch of items. Name, data source. Okay, full graphics mesh, mesh bones. Vertex components, vertex weights. Okay. This will probably be public soon, sooner or later. Let's go back to image pool. Is there anything specific for uploading types? Not really. Okay. Time for the loader. Actually, is this a name clash? This is also called foam mesh. Here, here, and here. Okay. Sure, that's still working. Yep. Okay, well, for private, oh, we're already in private. Just going to do two things at once, actually, this loader. Because right now I think it's still synchronous. Down here. So it'll be turned into an asynchronous system now. From the functions, the graphics stuff. I'll leave it like that for a moment. Vector system error mutex. Functional atomic. Not sure about array. Yes, it's an array. So the same as always. Where is that coming from? Not sure I'm getting it from this. Okay. Onto the loader. Okay. So, first few items, this and initialize and deinitialize. Initialized are pretty much the same. Okay. It's processing load requests. We'll be doing something like this, where we're going to have an upload system. Processing unload requests. Yeah, it does seem to be something that we're going to do. Except we are not. Hold on. What are the types we have? So, what's a mesh data? It's basically this. So how do we destroy a graphics mesh? I may be wondering. Well, the answer to that is we just need the session. So that's easy enough. Okay, that's the only thing we're unloading from here. It looks like. And then we've got to go into the actual upload process. Okay. That's for starting the upload. And we've got processing the upload. So what I'm going to do first is do the process upload one. Okay, once we have the mesh source, wait, hold on. Three types going on in here. Okay, what happens? We need to get to the point where we're... Okay, recorded. So we've at this point we've already submitted the upload request, which is checking for the end. So Basically, at this point, yeah. Then we need to swap the data in, which makes sense. Otherwise, we need to discard the data. Blah, 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 the data. Else it's incomplete. Basically the same thing. Then we're out of clean out there. Okay. Let's double check resource, status complete. Destroying the upload buffer, which we do either way. Though it's not done, we re-up it. Securing of the entry first. There are what, two items from mesh. Resource. Oh, I don't even have mesh yet. Do I? Or do I? Mesh, test mesh, mesh material, mesh frag shader, test armature. I don't actually have a test mesh yet. Probably should do that one first. Let's put that on the side for the moment. Technically, it's graphics data. There's no actual specific graphics data, is there? Okay, what do I use? What do I need from here? Find or create, add more mesh. Mesh the file, okay. We've also got what else? Cube. Okay, so we'll have three types. Something like that. Okay. So I need to go into here. No, I don't need that quite yet. File the mesh name. That's it. Oh. I can't return strings. I'm gonna have to return something specific. Okay. Okay. Base struct. Convert types. Oh boy. Dang. Okay, what I'm going to do for the moment is I'm just going to ignore these. We're just going to do this one. I can at least get something going, and then I'll re-expand it someday. Yeah, we'll just do. Let me try this on the application first. So, cube tower. Okay, we got two we can do. That's a sphere, that's cube, that goes sphere. So that's from source, that's from source. Okay. Okay. Okay, so at least the YAML's mostly working. Going back to mesh loader. We got this stuff. Oh, yeah, takes in two strings. So if error code fails, so some point clear all relevant data, that's great. For the part, this will be this. Don't need these. Otherwise, then we gotta start with all this stuff. This has got, so you need to get to this point, basically. Need to upload context. that something I don't have? Or, hold on. Yes, I do. File, okay, I wonder when it's file name. This requires this. Yeah, that's the one I wanted. That's got these weird little functions. Okay, mesh. VMA allocator, okay. Where is the upload buffer? There you are, get rid of view as well. To the application. I also need a mesh pool while I'm at it, actually. That should be easy enough. No, not here. disclose others. Same thing. This should really be a template at this point. It really should be. Okay. Where is it initialized? Is it not? Armature, material loader, okay. Function. Async task function. Deinitialize material loader. goes backwards. Really? Okay. Image loader will probably have another thing where, yeah. See if we even get to this point and what fails first. Okay. Excellent. Why is there an unload request already? Okay. Otherwise, there's another location or process upload where we do this. Old data. Because the mesh should start off with a blank data. Is that why? I'm automatic, so all data is automatically. I don't check it for if it's actual real data to be deleted. I just go ahead and try to delete it immediately anyways. Okay. So for drawing, we're doing, let's say, test mesh. Don't draw it until we actually have it. Okay. Not great. Okay. I don't actually have any bones. So that's why that. Okay. Dang it. Okay. Mesh bones, mesh bones, mesh bones. Presume that. Okay, mesh bones there. And in the mesh loader, I presume we're just not doing that.
Okay. Okay, we'll just do it here. Mesh data dot graphics bones. Just remove that. Prefer text bone weights. Components. Of course, there'll be a train going by. That equals components. All right, back to application. Try it with bones again. That's close. Not too bad. Turn bones off. If I turn bones off, then I don't get. Oh no, but I also. Oh yeah. Need to change the vertex descriptor for it. Okay, and then if we change to test mesh 2, which is the spherical one with the monkey at the top, I forget the name of it. Okay, we go back to true. Okay. So I don't need, go away, don't need mesh pool or mesh now. Except it does. Bool equals done. Put these down as that for the moment. So we can at least get rid of meshes. Get rid of that. One step closer. Okay, and then we want to make check if it's actually removing these items. I'm not sure if they will or are. Okay, that's fun. Something to do with. Sorry, what? Okay, that's cool. So something to do with the loading. Get rid of mesh pool. And the destruction as well. Okay, and then what if I was to like, I don't unique? I don't understand. Okay. What if I just let it be free for the moment? I'm just going to assume that the unique pointer destructor just isn't properly going through the virtual the V table to find the correct destructor. That's probably it. Okay. Then we've got a bunch of items that are being leaked around, which are most probably shader modules. Okay. That's probably because I'm bringing them in via this. Not properly decrementing them. Okay, this is something that, well, because use count was always more than one, so it would never actually run. Oh, it actually does properly delete everything when I properly have a proper use count of zero again. Okay. Nice. It just kind of leaves the animation kind of in between thing to deal with. This is using using a lot of stuff directly, which is not going to be fun to deal with. Not fun at all. Okay, hold on a second. second. Do I check if pmesh is loaded? Yes, but do I check if parameter is loaded? Material vertex descriptor, okay. What is it? Like, does it actually need? Okay, well, at least it doesn't require these things. But I'm not exactly sure how to handle this, like where it's going to be placed in the hierarchy. So I'm kind of tempted to just kind of leave it here for the moment. Don't want to. Okay. Hold on. Let's get these guys in at least. Mesh, 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 mesh stuff. Go. Get rid. Just kind of leaves the mesh. So at least I can have the generate for icosphere and cube stuff for the moment. Now I got to deal with the animation, which I guess I'll do next time instead. All right. Cheers.